Hi there. Welcome back to my channel. Today I will show you how I make this stylized character. It is not a detailed tutorial, it is an overview of the process, so let's begin. Let's start with base sculpting in ZBrush. I am using a sphere. Dynamesh it with 128 resolution. Here I am sculpting the head with basic facial anatomy knowledge, but I am also taking care of stylization as well. I mostly use standard brush, move brush, clay buildup, damn standard, trim dynamic and smooth brush a lot. Here I masked out the neck part and extrude it with the 3D transpose tool. I am also looking at the references of the actor, and understanding the proportions. Here I started the lips, it's very complicated. Sculpting the cheekbones. I am thinking that head proportion is not good, so I am masking the forehead and extrude it upwards. Here I added a sphere for the representation of his eyes. And then mirror it. Every time I add some details I instantly dynamesh it, to get better topology to work on. I am creasing the shapes using damn standard brush, and flattening the surface using trim dynamic brush. Try to view your sculpt with every view possible. I added a cube and shape it for his ears. And then mirror it. Dynamesh it as well. Now I added a sphere it and align it to his head for hair. This is just for volume reference purpose. We will add hair particles in Blender later on. Let me know you that I have no concept art or any idea references. I am just mismatching different ideas to create a cool stylized version of it. I do have the actor face references on my different screen. I am giving the eyes some colors to have some better view of the character. Here I added a new cube for his outfit. This is also be a rough sketch because later we will model proper cloths in Blender. Use trim curve to slice the mesh. Duplicate the mesh for the outer cloth. I am giving the colors to visually understand the model better. Here I am raising the DynaMesh resolution to work on more details. Here I am masking his eyebrows and extract it to a different mesh. Slicing the hard edges and then mirror it. I'm trying to shape every part. Thank you. Now I am masking for his beard. Extract it and shape it. Now I am merging the head and ears, and then dynamesh it with 2K resolution. Now because it is too heavy now, I am duplicating it and zerimesh one of them. Now subdivide the remeshed mesh and project the details from the high resolution mesh. Now add some more details to the new mesh. Now base sculpt is done. Export all the parts in OBJ format. Make sure parts which have subdivision are at its lower subdivision value while exporting. Now I am in Blender. Let's import all the pieces. Let's first model the inner cloth. I had added a plane and turn on the magnet option. Now trace the shape with new topology. I also added a mirror modifier to mirror the object. Now I am modeling the outer cloth. This has to be overlap, but it kills my mirror property, so I am intersecting this right now. Later I will overlap that in ZBrush in the stage of detailing. Now it's time for the cape. I didn't made it in ZBrush. I am making the folds on the cape with knife too. Added a solidify modifier to give it some thickness. Quickly giving some materials to the objects. To view it in render mode, I am roughly setting up the scene, visualizing what will be the final pose of him. At this point I feel that he should have a hand also with his gesture. So I quickly grab the body of my old character and delete everything other than hands. And now posing the hand. Because I am adding hand, I have to add some sort of body under the main cloth. So this is the kind of pose I will proceed with. I quickly add some lights and render out an image. Here it is. I added the background in Photoshop. This is very rough right now, but it had given me the picture which I am going to create. Tweaking some parts. When done, Let's export the new parts also in OBJ format and come to ZBrush for further details. Here's the model in ZBrush. I had quickly subdivide each part. Now add details like folds and uneven surfaces of the cloth. Now I had overlapped this part. I added this part here. It's rough right now. I will create the detailed object later in Blender. I had Z remesh the beard also. I think it's time to retopo his head, so I exported the head in OBJ in lowest subdivision level and also the highest one. Now import it in Blender. I imported the higher subdivision level version also. I am not retopologizing the whole head here, because it's just for an image render. So I will just delete the eyelid area, and recreate them, and also I will do the inner mouth. I am not caring about the edge flow here because it's just for an image render purpose. Now this is done, so I will do its UVs as well. Now export back to ZBrush. Import in ZBrush and add subdivisions and set the morph target. Now project the details from the Hyris model. When done, use the morph brush to clean the distorted mesh. Now you can add as much high poly details as you can, because now we will able to export the details in the form of displacement map. Now export the head, eyebrows, hair, and beard, because I will be doing the particle hair in Blender. In Blender, trace the eyebrows, beard, and hair scalp mesh. These meshes will have the hair particle system. Now let's group the ZBrush hair parts and hide it. And add the hair particle system and groom the hair. For the head scalp, I am doing two weight paint, one for the left hair part, and the other is for the right hair part. Now added the hair particles and start the grooming. I am referring the ZBrush model for the hair volume. I already have bunch of hair tutorials on my channel, if you want to understand the Blender hair system better. setting up some basic materials and hair settings to view the hair. I already have a bunch of hair tutorials on my channel, if you want to understand the Blender hair system better. In ZBrush, let's also export the cloth and hand model. Now I am importing the cloths which I had exported from ZBrush. Now we will adjust the mesh and do the UV unwrapping for the texturing process. Now let's model this part in Blender. The parts which I think are done after adjustments, I apply all the modifiers and do the UV unwrapping. Now all the UV unwrappings are done. Now select all the parts and export them into OBJ. In ZBrush now we will do the final detailing like cloth wrinkles, creases and folds, because from here we will able to generate the displacement maps for Blender materials. Let's readjust this part in Blender. Now everything in ZBrush is done, now I will export the objects final time for Blender. Bake the displacement map of each and every object. In Blender, import all final objects here. Now select all the objects and export all in a single OBJ file for texturing. Now I am in Substance Painter for texturing. Import the OBJ. Let's start with head, bake the maps of head. Add the preset skin material to the head and hand. I am adding the universal redness, yellowness and bluishness on the face. Now this is some additional detailing. I am adding some texture XYZ textures for pores and skin details. When I added the texture XYZ details, I lower the opacity of color value and height value. You see these artifacts? In Blender, let's push down the lower body from the head, so that head is no longer in contact with the body, because I will replace this mesh, and rebake the maps of head to avoid the artifacts. Now let's jump on the cloths. If you want a detailed texturing tutorial in Substance Painter, I have a tutorial for that on my channel, check my description. I imported a pattern for the cape border. I am not using a detailed pattern because I am making a stylized character here. I need some light and dark strips in this cloth. So in Blender, select the object, and add edge loops. And apply white and black materials alternatively. And bake the texture. Oh, I forgot to unwrap this object, so I quickly unwrap this in Blender and export back in Substance Painter. Now all the texturing work is done, export the maps. Arrange your texture maps in folders. Put the body back to its position, parent all object with an empty. And now add all the textures in the material. Most important to add ZBrush displacement map. Import your displacement map. Change the displacement setting of the material to displacement and bump. Add a displacement node and assign the texture to the height socket and displacement to displacement socket. Now, add your Substance Painter textures, color map, roughness and normal OpenGL map. When you add the normal map, the bump of the displacement map will replaces. So add a bump node and add the displacement map in the height socket and normal in the normal socket. Now add the subsurface scattering to the material with random walk. I am using saturated color for the subsurface color. Similarly assign each and every material, use the displacements and Substance Painter maps. Keep this in mind that you have to use subdivision surface modifier in order to work displacement map. Because he has color variation in his hair, I quickly exported the scalp model with UVs, and painted the color in Substance Painter. Now I can use that color map as color value for the hair shader. So, when every material is done, add some good lightings, render your model, and composite that using After Effects or Photoshop. It's not easy to create stylized characters, I myself did so many attempts to achieve the good result. So this is it for this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel for more of this type of content. Peace.